Welcome back. The second piece that we're going to put on this wall has been cut, and it will lay in there just like so. I guess I gotta put it in the other way. Let me go ahead and stick it this way first. There we go. So that will go in there like that, and you'll notice it's nice and even along this edge. A couple of clamps are gonna smear. I'll put quite a bit of glue on this back side, and then clamp them. I have some clamps that will reach in there pretty far with some wooden blocks. And once that's all dried, then I'll take one of these leftover gluing, and I'll stick one down there like that, and we'll glue that down. And then I'll put another one here, and probably another one over on this side. So we'll have one here, here, and here. And this will be nice and even. I don't know, I might even put a small wedge one right there, I don't know. We'll worry about that when the time comes. But that's just about going to take care of our problem. Then, of course, I'll have to put this molding back on the other side. But I didn't want this thing sitting at an angle while I'm trying to glue it and mess with it. So that's what's going on so far. Let's get that done. I'm putting plenty of glue on this thing because I really want it to be held well. I want these two pieces to become one piece. So I just dribble that. Just dribbled quite a bit of it on there. Now I'm going to go ahead and really smear it good, especially around this edge right here. This is the edge that sticks out. I want it to be really good. So I'll finish this. I'll put a little more glue on it, spread a little more around. Then we'll put the clamps on it. Probably the best thing to happen with this kind of method of spreading glue is if you get something that drips off the edge, you know, so much the better. You know, it's just more glue to hold it in. The best way to do it would have been with a hard roller, the kind that old Norm Abrams used to use in his shop. You know, I don't have any of those, of course, so this works just as good. It gets it spread around the way I want. Glob plenty of glue on if you ever happen to have to glue two pieces of wood together. Hopefully you never have to do it, but you know, I guess I could have gone with a thicker piece of wood instead of 2/4 inch pieces, but you know, I didn't do it, so we'll go with this. All right, spread that extra glue. Let's get this thing set in the cabinet now. It's going to take two hands since it's so gooey. The important thing here is to get this back edge nice and flush with the other piece. You want it nice and flush. Down in here really doesn't matter so much because I said, like, you know, gluing blocks are going to cover all that up anyway. But right here, this is what will get exposed to where everybody sees it. Now, I might lift that up and put me another line, a bead of glue in there, so when I press it down, I want to see plenty of glue squeeze out of that thing. My son bought me, he knows I do cabinet work, he bought me some Craftsman squeeze clamps for Christmas. I thought that was pretty nice. I didn't think they'd come in handy quite so soon, but look at here. All I gotta do is put it there and then squeeze it and it's done. One-handed clamps. I love these things. These are really cool. He bought me some small ones and some large ones. I may have to go in and get a couple of small ones here. All right. There we go. Nice and even. I like that. That looks good. All right. All we have to do now is get some clamps in here to clamp all this down in place, and that'll come next. Probably the biggest headache in repairing a cabinet is never having enough clamps, or not having the right clamps, or not having enough clamping blocks, or not the right kind of clamping blocks. You got to search through all your stuff, and then you have to kind of jury-rig it and get it to work. Never fails, you know, so this is the way I was able to do it. I ran my clamps in through the holes in the front and pressed down on some jury-rig clamping blocks here to get that side down. The rest, like I said, will come from gluing blocks. But this is all put back together now, all clamped nice and even. And we'll just let it dry now. But next time I go to my favorite little place where I buy these kinds of clamps and everything, I think I'll pick up some longer kind, you know, the kind that reaches way into a cabinet. One more thing I wanted to show you here. This is one of the blocks that was nailed to the inside of the cabinet. It held the battery in place, kept the battery, since this is a farm, you know, radio battery operated set. They didn't want the batteries to move, so they they nailed this thing. They put some glue on it, of course, and then just nailed it into the cabinet. And I had to remove it in order to put the double wall in. But sometimes you'll remove a piece of molding or anything from inside of an old cabinet, doesn't matter what kind, and the nails will be there. My recommendation is don't try to bang those nails out. You'll wind up damaging the wood, and you may have to use the block over again. Better to just take a pair of needle nose pliers and just work it back and forth like so and pop those things off flush, okay? And then if there's a slight bit sticking out, fortunately there's not here, I'll have to trim off this piece of wood, of course, that came off with it. But, you know, if you break them off nice and flush, and then if you want, you can take them and put them on a piece of emery cloth or something like that, run them back and forth to smooth them down even more. Just leave the nails in. It doesn't hurt a thing. And you can still glue it. It's the next morning, and it's time to remove these clamps. Right after I shut off the camera last time, I decided to go ahead and put this one in here, which reaches down pretty much into the center as far as it can go. Squeeze that up in there too. So I got a really good clamping all the way around with what I had, you know, the materials I had and the clamps I had. So let's go ahead and get these off there and see what it looks like. Not too bad. Nice and solid. That's what I like to see. Nice and strong. Let me see. Today I think what I'll do is mess around a little bit. We'll put a little bit of fill wood in that hole right there and glue it in. Then we'll have to probably, you know, trim it off even tomorrow. I think I can get by with this. This will be fine just the way it is. And then looks like we've got a little bit of veneer here that needs to be re-glued. I think I'll go ahead and take care of that also. And we'll put the gluing blocks in. Once again, after I get some glue down underneath that veneer there, all I have to do is take my little old one-hand clamps and put on there and give it a squeeze, and that'll be all it takes. I mean, that's no wood. I don't need to use any wood blocks or anything. Boy, these things are cool. I'm going to have to get some more of these things. And the last thing to check before we lay on the molding and do a few other things is this fluted column right here is now a lot straighter than it was. It's off maybe a 1/16 of an inch in this direction. But boy, I'll tell you what, that's a big improvement from what it was. That's as straight as I'm going to be able to get it. I just can't pull it in anymore without it completely breaking off the front of the cabinet because of its warpage. Well, we're just about ready to take off the last of the clamps, and I still have to cut off some fill wood I glued in this hole right here. I'll just take my motor tool, whack that off, sand it down, and then this is kind of rough. You can even hear it. I'll go ahead and sand that down nice and smooth to where we get, you know, a much softer sound. And it'll be real nice. Then, you know, put a little fill wood along these little chips like I had mentioned earlier. We have our molding all the way around the front. Looks really nice now. Well, I'll tell you what, looks exactly like that one over there. So all I got to do now is fill in the slot I was telling you about, that space, that gap. I've decided to go ahead and fill it in with veneer and trim it off and see what happens. Inside we have our brace wood all the way around. Let me get this over here. Got a piece of brace wood along the bottom, along this side, a couple of pieces on the front here, and then one along here. And all we gotta do is come up with some kind of a corner wedge similar to this one, and I'll stick it right here to match. And that's what I'll be working on next. Hopefully, once I release all the clamps and get all those things taken care of, the next video we can go ahead and start stripping. Before ending the video, we're back to my little stereo setup here. I moved the cassette deck up to there and took out the turntable, moved it to the top so I have more room now where I can lift the lid. Should have done that to begin with. And I put the speakers up on the wall above it, so they're off of there. And of course, all Lowe's had was these white shelf brackets, so in the spring when it gets warmer and I can go outside and do some painting on it, I'll paint them brown. But they're doing real good. But I got all this nice old-fashioned, you know, vintage stuff here, and of course we're not listening to it right now. You know what we're listening to? We're listening to this. When the an iPhone hooked to an Extreme Mac something or other. I don't even know what it's called. Extreme Mac whatever thingy. This belongs to wifey, next to all my classic vintage gear, and maybe not the top of the line, but you know, I mean, come on. Bad wifey. Bad, bad, bad. I don't hear anything. Bad.
I like my music.
Bad wifey, bad.
I like my music. And I like the way it's coming.
You like it coming out of your iPhone. Do you realize this could be grounds for divorce? Do you realize that?
As long as I get to keep my music. That's all I care about.
Last but not least, I want to send this song out to one of my loyal video watchers, Tim, AM station engineer. I know that this is one of his favorite artists, and I just wanted to play it for him to let him know that I appreciate him watching my videos and, you know, leaving me plenty of messages and comments all the time. He's a good feller. So here you go, Tim, all for you. I know you love this. You young folks out there that may not know what this is The Way We Were, being sung by Barbara Streisand. She made a movie years ago, around 1975, I guess it was. Yeah, I think it was 75. And the name of the movie was The Way We Were. And this was this theme song. And I just loved the movie, and I loved the theme song. And I think, even though Barbara's political views are a little messed up, you have to admit, she's just a terrific singer. I just loved her. I got lots of her albums. So there you go, Tim. AM station engineer. All for you, buddy. Until next time, this is John.